各位朋友大家好，欢迎收看今天英文翻译第14次播出。今天主题是英汉句法的异同。首先介绍跟我一块主持节目的魏老师。
Hi. Howdy. Jane and, 大家好，欢迎收看，and let's hope you learn something today.
好，正如魏老师所说的，希望大家在每一次的课程当中都能学到一些东西。来，先到我们的第一部分。Principles of Translation, 翻译原理。英汉语言中的句法的异同可以分两方面来讨论。第一个是句子的功能，第二是句子的结构。句子的功能方面呢，那英语中的句子可以依它的功能，我们分五种。第一种是叙述句
，declarative sentence。
第二种是疑问句
，interrogative sentence。
第三种祈使句
，imperative sentence。
第四种感叹句
，exclamatory sentence。
第五种祈愿句
，optative sentence。
还有五种，所以其实在汉语中也有这五种的句子。我们来说明一下，英语中这个句子刚刚说功能有这个五类哈，那么汉语的也有这五类，我们可以做个对照。譬如第一类是叙述句
，declarative sentence。We know that the United Nations is an international organization。
我们知道联合国是个国际性的组织，这是一个叙述句，两个都是有直述句的。那联合国叫 The United Nations 有复数啊，同学要记起来。好，我们看下一种句子，疑问句
，interrogative sentence。Is he a CIA investigator？
他是中情局调查员吗？这个 CIA 是个缩写，我想问Charles， 他们是 stand for what？
Central Intelligence Agency。
中央情报局哈、
yes.
，Central Intelligence Agency。好，那我们再看下一句。
Does she often fail to keep her word？
她时常不守诺言吗？这边有个片语你要记得 ，keep one's word 就是守诺言哈 ，fail to 是没有办法守诺言。好，我们看刚刚这个疑问句里面，我们多半是用be 动词放前面。那如果助动词有 does 或者 do 放前面，这跟中文不一样，我们中文加一个 ma 就好，对不对？那英文要用助动词哈或 be 动词来做疑问句。好，我们看下一种祈使句
imperative sentence。 Be nice to your friends，
好好对待你的朋友，这祈使句有点命令的意思哈。我们看下一个感叹句
exclamatory sentence。How lovely her hair is.
她的秀发多美啊，感叹时候你可以用 how 开始， how 后面要接形容词 lovely 哈。
What lovely hair she has.
也是感叹句，她有着多美的秀发，但是你用 what 开始的时候要 what a lovely hair， 要一个加一个名词哈。好，我们再看祈愿句
optative sentence. May you succeed.
祝你成功。
God bless you.
愿神祝福你，这是祈愿句。好，句子的结构我们看到，英语中的句子依它结构可以分为四种。那在翻译的时候呢，英语的句子结构有时候可以在汉语中保留，但有时候要做一点小的转换哈。我们看英语的一些结构，它有单句哈。
Simple sentence.Flower arrangement is one of her interests.
插花是她兴趣之一，我们就直接这样翻，这个原来的句子的结构保留了。合句
Compound sentence. He hated to go to school and he constantly ran away from home.
他讨厌上学，而且经常离家出走，这两个句子结构也很类似，保留了。下面复句
Complex sentence. The small town has become so prosperous because it is a nice place to vacation.
这个小镇因为是个度假的好地方， 所以变得这么繁荣。在翻的时候，你看到没有？我们把原因放前面 ，because 这个句子到前面去，所以结构有点变化。下面复合句
，compound complex sentence。When he was young, he enjoyed reading and he wanted to be a writer.
他年轻的时候喜欢阅读，并想做个作家。我们把这个结构直接保留。好，英语中还有一些比较特殊的句子结构，譬如说它有一些强调句子，要用这个虚字 it 做句首，还有一些倒装句，还有被动语态等。在汉语中，这种句型会比较少。我们说明一下。
It is impossible to release the spy immediately.
这是个强调句，用 it 开始哈。那翻中文的时候，这 it 是一个虚字，我们都没有翻，就直接说立即释放这名间谍是不可能的。下面
，Never have I seen such a gorgeous vase.
这是个倒装句，它原来意思是 I have never seen such a gorgeous vase.我从未见过这么精美的花瓶，这种倒装句在我们汉语里面是没有的。
Only after the accident did he have his car inspected.
这是个倒装句 ，only 开始哈，原来是说 he only had his car inspected after the accident。那我们就中文直接说车祸后他才把车去送检，汉语当中没有倒装句。
The highway.Was extended as far as our town.
这是个被动式 was extended. 可是我们翻中文的时候，我们比较多是用主动表示，公路延长到我们镇上。
Vegetable sandwiches are sold out.
好，那这也是个被动，叫 are sold out. 可是我们翻时，我们多半就说蔬菜三明治卖完了。汉语中比较多是主动的形式哈。好，那这是我们今天的 Principles of Translation 一些句子的结构，翻译的时候你要注意一下。下面看我们的 Famous Quotations 中外名言。先礼后兵。
Words first, blows later.
对牛弹琴。
To cast pearls before swine.
来得快，去得也快。
Easy come, easy go.
逆境时天才显露，顺利时天才埋没。
Adversity reveals genius, fortune conceals it.
不自由，勿宁死。
Give me liberty or give me death.
好，这是我们今天的中外名言部分哈。那我们先到这休息一下。现在看看我们今天绘画的一些单字 vocabulary and expressions.
Turn off.
关掉，使人失去兴趣。
Switch.
转换。
Channel.
频道。
Kind of.
有一点。
Version.
版本。
Convince.
确信。
Series,
连续剧
Ham,
火腿
Leftovers,
剩菜饭
Go with,
与什么搭配
Gallon,
加仑
Jug,
水罐
Convey,
护送
Stop off,
逗留下车
Fast food restaurant.
素食店
Check mark.
查核做记号
Order sheet.
点餐单
Regular.
固定的
Standard.
标准的
Type.
形式种类
Run.
经营
Apply for
申请
License
执照
Shoulder
承担
bookkeeping
簿记
task
工作
keep up with
跟上
excuse
原谅
expression
措辞
tax accounting
税务会计
above board
光明正大的
straight
正直的诚实的
hold back
隐瞒
slim majority
略超过一半
fair
诚实的公平的
share
份儿
amount
总数总额
the lion's share
大部分
revenue
税入税收，这是我们今天的单词部分。我们下面请同学来看一下今天绘画的英文部分。
You turned that off so fast. Switch channels anyhow.
It kind of turned me off too.I've already seen the film version 3 times, and I'm still convinced the book is so much better.
Which means you just can't stay interested in the weekly series. The book will get your attention for sure, since you grew up in that town. Say, this is the 4th time you've gotten up in the last half hour or so.
Yes, to get a cold drink. Same as you. Maybe it's the ham we had for supper.
It's a good thing we didn't eat it all. The kids will want some leftovers when they return from the out-of-town football game, unless it's really late.
And some ice water to go with it. I already filled a gallon jug. It should be ready for them when they get home.
Unless their bus convoy stops off at some fast food restaurant, like ours used to do when we traveled too far away and got back well past midnight.
I remember that only too well,including how they checkmarked their order sheet that had a picture of each item. The day I started my first regular job, I looked for it on the ticket, but couldn't find it.
Sure, most places only use the standard types, like Mom did for the business she ran at our house. She had to apply for a license and showed her the bookkeeping tasks.
And keep up with, excuse the expression, tax accounting.
No question about that.Your family and mine always did such things at the bar and play straight, never held back. Let a slim majority back stateside who do pay their fair share, which amounts to the lion's share of government revenue.
好，你们听到刚刚有讲的 the lion's share, 狮子那一份，什么意思啊 ，Charles?
Well, it means bigger.Portion than many, if not most, would get. It's because it's obvious because lions have a big appetite. See, they eat more than most other animals. So、mm-hmm. it would be, I mean, if all the animals ate, you know, all in the same place, you could see that lions would eat more than most of them.
好，所以 the lion's share 就是说比较大的部分，吃比较多的部分哈。好，我们再把这个英文的绘画。来看看我们中文的翻译。
You turned that off so fast. Switch channels anyhow.
It kind of turned me off too. I've already seen the film version 3 times, and I'm still convinced the book is so much better.
Which means you just can't stay interested in the weekly series. The book will get your attention for sure, since you grew up in that town.Say, this is the 4th time you've gotten up in the last half hour or so.
Yes, to get a cold drink. Same as you. Maybe it's the ham we had for supper.
It's a good thing we didn't eat it all. The kids will want some leftovers when they return from the out-of-town football game, unless it's really late.
And some ice water to go with it. I already filled a gallon jug.It should be ready for them when they get home.
unless their bus convoy stops off at some fast food restaurant, like ours used to do when we traveled too far away and got back well past midnight.
I remember that only too well, including how they check marked their order sheet that had a picture of each item. The day I started my first regular job, I looked for it on the ticket, but couldn't find it.
Sure, most places only use the standard types, like Mom did for the business she ran at our house. She had to apply for a license and showed her the bookkeeping tasks.
And keep up with, excuse the expression, tax accounting.
No question about that. Your family and mine always did such things as a bore and play straight, never held back. Let a slim majority back stateside who do pay their fair share, which amounts to the lion's share of government revenue.
How 有时候你回家吃一些剩下的菜饭叫 leftovers, 这可以记下来哈。来我们看看今天的绘画的问题部分 questions。
Question one, what are these people doing? A, reading novels, B, playing cards, C, watching TV, D, cooking food.
C, watching TV.
Question two, what observation does the woman make about the man? A, he is sleepy, B, he is irritable, C, he is sad, D, he is thirsty.
D, he is thirsty.
Question three, what time of year does the conversation probably take place? A, autumn, B, winter, C, spring, D, summer.
A, autumn.
Question four, what is probably the relation between these people? A, brother and sister, B, husband and wife, C, co-workers, D, we can't tell from the story.
B, husband and wife. How?这是我们今天绘画部分下面让我们做一下Let's practice 句型翻译练习
I've already seen the film version 3 times and I am still convinced the book is so much better
我看了三次改编的电影我还是相信书比较好我们来做 convince 深信坚信我完全相信约翰是无辜的。
I am absolutely convinced that John is innocent. I am absolutely convinced that John is innocent.
好，哪一个对了？
You need an adverb to, because convinced is a verb form.
Mm-hmm.
So absolute is an adjective, maybe a noun, but it's not an adverb.
好，这句你看 ，convinced 这是一个动词。要修饰动词要用副词 absolutely 那这个 absolute 是一个形容词或者名词那就错了哈我们看另外的翻译法
I harbor no doubts of John's innocence
harbor no doubts 就是我想的意思哈哇这个没有什么怀疑我一点都不怀疑约翰他是无辜的好我们看下一句他坚信他的决定是对的
He convinced that his decision was correct. He was convinced that his decision was correct.
好，看看哪边有错。
The first one's ungrammatical.
第一句话说。
Need an auxiliary verb.
不是合法，不合文法哈。你看 ，he convinced. 我们都说 he was convinced. 这个多半就用 be 动词加上 convinced 啊，就是我们一个基本的用法。好，我们看看另外的翻法。
He firmly believed he had taken the right path.
好，很确定的相信 ，firmly believed。来，我们到这儿，先来休息一下。好，我们看看这个例句，给大家看一下。
It means you just can't stay interested in the weekly series.
这代表你对每周的连续剧无法保持兴趣。我们要学 stay interested, 保持兴趣。 为何你对任何事情都无法保持兴趣呢？
Why can't you stay interested in anything? Why can't you stay interesting in anything?
好，哪边有错？
Well, you say you are interested. See, that means you feel interest. But if you say you are interesting, it means others feel interest about you.
嗯哼，你对什么事有兴趣是 stay interested， 用 ed 哈。你有 ing 是表示说别人觉得你很有趣，你说他是一个很有趣的人哈，别人觉得你有趣，不是你自己觉得有兴趣。好，这个 ed 跟 ing 有差别，同学要记得。我们另外看看怎么翻。
How is it that your interest always fades?
好，我们学一个 fade， 就是消失了哈，减弱了。你的兴趣为什么消失哈？会总是消失呢？好，我们看下一个。好笑的动作可以让听众保持兴趣，动作叫 gesture。
Funny gestures can make your audiences stay interested.Funny gestures can make your audiences to stay interested.
好，哪边有错？
When we use make in this sense, we don't put to with it. So the first one's grammatical.
好，第一个对，第二个不对。第一个是合乎文法，第二个为什么不合乎文法呢？你看 make， 以前我们说过实义动词 make 什么人，那后面要用原形，不能加 to 了哈。Make your audiences， 我们用复数 audiences。Stay interested. 好，这是一个实义动词，我们不能够加 to。我们看另外的说法。
Unusual motions may hold your viewers' interest.
好，我们看 funny gesture 很好笑的动作，或者 unusual motion 动作是 motions， 让你的 viewers 观众听众哈觉得会 hold 就是掌握住他们的兴趣。这句话写的也很好。来，下面。
The kids will want some leftovers when they return from that out-of-town football game, unless it's really late.
除非真的太晚，否则孩子们从城外足球比赛完回来，会想要吃些剩菜饭的。我们学一个 return from， 从哪边回来？他刚刚从苏格兰回来，显得很疲劳。
He just returned from Scotland and seemed to be very tired. He just returned from Scotland and seemed very tired.
哪边有错？
The first one sounds like Chinglish and it also is ungrammatical.
好，第一句就是好像很多中文人都这样说哈，中国人这样说。你看这个 seemed 似乎是非常的疲惫，那似乎是动词了。这个是的 be 动词不要再加了。很多同学常常喜欢用 be 哈，到处都用 be， 不可以一个动词就好了。来，我们看另外的说法。
He looked beat upon arriving back from Scotland.
好 ，beat 是本来是打败的意思，看起来很疲惫、很疲倦。upon 是当 arriving， 这个 upon 是介系词，所以后面用 arriving 这个学起来哈。从 Scotland 回来。好，我们看下一句。孩子们很兴奋，因为爸爸快下班了。
The children were very excited because their dad was returning from work. The children were very exciting because their dad was returning from work.
哪一个错了？
Well, again, the children were exciting means that's how other people feel to them, but the children were excited is how they feel.
好，我们跟刚刚 interested, interesting 一样哈。那 exciting 是别人觉得他们好像非常令人兴奋的。那他自己是 excited 的，所以我们讲 ing 就是令人怎么样。如果孩子们自己觉得很兴奋，是 excited， 好，那这是一个差别了。好，我们另外来翻翻看。
Their father's coming home from his job got the children keyed up。
哎，这个 keyed up 很有趣，就是说孩子们很兴奋、很高兴，这个 keyed up 可以学起来。来看下面。
Unless。Their bus convoy stops off at some fast food restaurant like ours used to do when we traveled too far away and got back well past midnight.
除非接送的巴士在某些速食店前停车，就像我们过去也常因为旅途遥远， 过大半夜才到家这么做。我们来学 used to 过去常有的习惯。我以前在台北读书时常搭捷运上学。
I used to taking MRT to school when I studied in Taipei. I used to take MRT to school when I studied in Taipei.
哪一个错？
First one's ungrammatical.
好，这不合文法。I used to. Used to 后面要加动词原形，不要加 ing 哈。另外说说看。
Formerly, I rode the subway to class in Taipei.
好，以前叫 formerly, rode the subway. 好，我们这个地铁哈，叫捷运叫 subway。来，我们看下一句。我在美国时常去纽约看不同的表演。
I used to go to New York to see different shows when I stayed in the USA. I used to go to the New York to see different shows when I stayed in the USA.
哪一个错了？
We don't put the with New York unless it's got something after it. Like we'll say the New York Fire Department or something, but.Just to say this.
所以我们就讲地点的时候都不加 the 哈，除非以外的状况。那普通这个专有名词不加 the 哈。好了，我们看另外说法。
While living stateside, I formerly trekked to theaters in the Big Apple.
好，去哪边用 trek 这字也可以哈。那么这个美国他们称为是 the Big Apple 哈，这个叫 the 了。来，我们看下面。
She had to apply for a license.And shoulder the bookkeeping tasks.
他必须申请执照，并且承担记账的工作。我们要学 apply for 申请、请求。玛丽大学毕业后申请这份差事。
Mary applied the job after she graduated from university. Mary applied for the job after she graduated from university.
哪边错了？
The first one sounds like Chinglish, because we say apply for in this sense.
嗯哼，第一个讲不对，因为我们中文好像比较没有这 for 介词的概念，这边是要加 for 哈。好，另外说说看。
Upon earning her bachelor's degree, Mary sought employment with this firm.
好，我们要学起来 ，bachelor's degree 就是我们学士学位 ，earning 是得到哈，那么 sought 寻求工作哈。好，像这一句，我必须申请奖学金才能出国念书。出国念书叫 study abroad。
I have to apply for the scholarship in order to study abroad. I have to apply for the scholarship in order to read abroad.
好，哪一个错？
The second one's definitely Chinglish.
同学，你学的念书啊，念书不是 read， 这个不一样哈，要 study 哈。来，我们另外翻翻看。
A scholarship looms as sine qua non for my overseas study.
好，这个 sine qua non 什么意思
？That's Latin for without which not. That's literally what it means.
这拉丁字就说没有 A 就没有 B 的意思哈，就说你没有奖学金，你就不能出国念书了。好，这是我们今天看到这里。同学，其实有些英文字要在另外这个努力学的哈。你看拉丁字也在里面的，希望你学的很多。那下回见啦，再见，拜拜。